Radio Network. Mets beat the Red Sox 5-4. Nats scored 5 unanswered to beat the Marlins 7-4. Abraham Almonte's grand slam in the 5th powered the Indians to a 9-2 victory and a sweep of the Angels. Twins topped the Strohs 7-5. Rangers blanked the Orioles 6-0. Rays edged the Royals 3-2. And the Rockies scored 3 in the 4th to blank the Pirates 5-0. Preseason football. Texans up on the Saints 13-6 in the 3rd. Raiders hosting the Cardinals 8 Eastern on NBC. Listen to NBC Sports Radio on air, online, and on the mobile app. Dave Joseph, NBC Sports Radio.
Kcaa Loma Linda.
Consider this your invitation to sell. At BuySellMakeOffer.com, you can sell as much as you want for the next 60 days without paying any fees whatsoever. Sound incredible? It is, and it's true. BuySellMakeOffer.com is the new exciting way to sell your stuff online. Make extra money right now. Sell your old car, furniture, video games, household items, clothes, even your home. Sell anything that's legal. Load up your stuff to sell right now at BuySellMakeOffer.com. This is your official invitation to get on board to sell your stuff right now. Free for the next 60 days. And once you see how easy it is, you'll want to sign up for more because there are no item fees. That's right. Take this opportunity to move items from the other guys and sell it for free. You might even win a Samsung tablet, Amazon gift cards, and other cool prizes. BuySellMakeOffer.com is the future of online selling. You can use Skype to talk to your buyer or seller. Plus, you can use video to showcase your items. BuySellMakeOffer.com.
When Long Palm Springs is the one where you get big water park fun. Barefootin' in the sun, barefootin', flow rider barefootin', wet and wild barefootin'. Bring your friends and stay all day. Wet n' Wild is your place to play barefootin'.
Yeah, you gotta get barefootin' this summer at Wet n' Wild. Dive into all the thrills, all the action, all the fun. Take on awesome slides and rides. There's big fun for kids and much more. This summer, we have extended hours, dive-in movies every Friday, and everyone gets free tubes. Plus, save $7 on admission when you buy online or grab discount coupons at area Jack in the Box restaurants. For your best summer ever, it's Wet n' Wild.
Slipping, sliding, barefooting, getting soaked, barefooting, wet n' wild, barefooting.
Wet n' Wild.
Barefooting. Wet n' Wild barefooting.
Wet n' Wild. Park open daily.
Kcaa 1050. The station that leaves no listener behind. AM on your dial.
And I don't feel good when I got no pain. And that's all I'm gonna say. And I don't give a damn about my bad reputation.
Oh, no, 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 no.
Not me.
Machine. I knew he must have been about 17. He was strong, playing my favorite song. And I could tell it wouldn't be long that he was with me, yeah, me. And I could tell it wouldn't be long that he was with me, yeah, me. It's all the same. So I'll take you home where we can be alone. Next we're moving on. He was with me, yeah, me. Next we're moving on. He was with me.
I'm Good afternoon, gente, and this is the Commiss right here along with JoJo Sanchez from Devotions Entertainment and DJ CX2, and our special guest DJ this afternoon is Mr. Ben Valdepeña with First Class Entertainment out there in the city of Yucaipa. Welcome, everybody. How you guys doing today?
Doing good, man. How are you?
Everybody's silent. What's going on? Everybody tired from yesterday?
We're just waiting for you to finish talking, man.
Oh, man. I thought I had finished.
Rude.
Oh, I thought I had finished.
My father taught me how to respect. Come on.
All right. You got to talk a little closer to the mic, bro. Because then not.
I would. My mustache was in the way.
If not, man, Joe's going to get little.
He starts sending out signals from the window.
Have to turn up your mic. You know, we don't want Joe, you know, to get a hand cramp or anything like that. Yeah, there you go.
Scoliosis is in the fingers.
Yeah. So, and then also we have a couple of guests with us today from T-Mobile. We have Janine Sosa, one of the store managers, is going to be talking a little bit about some of the specials they have going on with T-Mobile. And then also we have City Council member Bill Hussey with us today. We're going to be bringing on air in about 20 minutes or so. But I just wanted to talk, you know, we did go out to the car show or the bicycle show out there in the city of Colton with the Colton Community Coalition for Change. And it was a great family event. Man, there was tons of bicycles that came out, and I really appreciate all the car clubs that came out and supported it. You know, the Vejitos, Street Life, Majestics, Kefime Car Club was out there. You know, and we really appreciate all your support, man. You know, our event yesterday was put a message
out. Let's get female. He's right here. Let's look at the back of the shirt because I like it.
Come on over here. Eh?
On this side over here.
Yeah, here comes Ruben right here.
Turn around. Check out your backside. See, look at it.
Get female car club, huh?
I like that.
With Felix the cat, dude. You don't see Felix around.
I see him all the time in front of a bomb.
Yeah, I see Splinter and the Ninja Turtles always hanging out around me.
Says this guy.
But anyways, man, you know, right now what I'd like to do is just, first of all, well, let's congratulate Ruben because he came by here. He left a little early yesterday from the show, but
his trophy yesterday.
We raffled his trophy off? So you forgot to bring it?
You're going to be so mad at me right now.
What?
I borrowed my mom's RV yesterday for the entertainers. I put your plaque in there. My dad called me last minute. I'll take Krishna home, my son. I was like, cool. So we jumped in Aries' car, and I got halfway here. I looked at your folder because someone told me to bring the folder they forgot.
But I called you earlier and said, bring Ruben's plot.
I have a mentally institutional mind inside my head.
I should have sent a message, man. See?
I got
what
your
happens?
Message. And I left it right there in the RV, and I'm calling my mom. Hey, I'm going to bring your RV tomorrow. I have to go on. I'm running late.
Voicemail.
I'll bring it to your house.
Okay. Ruben, man, we're sorry about that, bro. No, I thought the plaque was coming, but you know what, man? He won yesterday.
It's still coming.
It's, you know, you were selected, or the judges gave you the award of
first
place street custom, right?
60 Street.
60 Street custom. Yeah, so
like yesterday when we did it, we let the kids, they all did all the judging.
Oh, really?
Oh, it was all messed up, but they did it. I'm not going to lie. They tried.
I didn't see anybody judging. I was wondering.
No, what we did is because we knew we were sure-handed and it was hot, we got them out there. Right when you guys were done, they were on them.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So,
they were in there. They were doing them. And
well, hey, Ruben, look at it this way, dude. At least we got you live on the air right here, man. People are watching, and they know that you're getting a trophy for first place, man. And you know what? Thank you for coming by here. I'm sorry that... You know,
no, he's not sorry. I'm sorry.
All right. I'm not sorry.
I just wanted to mention that the car club, my car club's coming out.
Come on, you got to talk a little closer to the mic.
My car club's coming out hopefully the middle of next month, the end of next month.
Okay.
Get feed me. We're getting our plaques, got our banner, got our T-shirts.
Working on it.
Hopefully, God willing, we'll be done, ready to come out next month.
Wonderful. Yeah, great.
Wait, but just say you're
I'm the president.
All right. Well, and that takes a lot of work putting these clubs together, man. You know, you got to have bylaws and everything. So there's a lot of regulations when it comes to creating the club. But congratulations, man. And just let me get a shout out to our sponsors, Sapo Plastics out here in the city of San Bernardino, and then Farmers Insurance Group. James and Lupita Jimenez. Call them for a free quote on auto, life, business insurance if you need it, liability insurance. They also have that at 1-888-542-8332. And then we have J&P Beef Jerky in the city of Highland. You can look them up on Facebook. And we also have our one of my favorite places, and our major sponsor is El Aguila Real Restaurant right there in the city of Colton on C Street and Rancho Avenue. And actually, we had a Friday night cruise a couple Fridays ago, and great turnout. You know, the clubs continue to come out there and support our local businesses, man. And, you know, Street Live, City's Finest. Now we're going to have
Kefime
Car Club out there now. And, you know, Early Pride. You know, appreciate all you guys coming out there and supporting it. So with that, we're going to go with Ben Valdepeña from First Class Entertainment. Take us away with some great music, Ben.
For one heart to carry on. You're way on top now since you left me. You're always laughing way down at me. But watch out now, I'm gonna get there. We'll be together for just a little while, and then I'm gonna put you way down here, and you'll start crying 96 tears. Comes up, I'll be on top. You be right down there, looking up. And I might wave, come up here, but I don't see you waving now. I'm way down here, wondering how I'm gonna get to you, but I know now. I'll just cry. Too many teardrops for one heart to be crying. Too many teardrops for one heart to carry on. You're gonna cry 96 tears. You're gonna cry 96 tears. You're gonna cry, 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 cry now. You're gonna cry. Come on, let me hear you cry now. 96 tears. Woo! I wanna hear you cry. Night and day. Yeah, all night long. 96 tears. Cry, cry, cry. Come on, baby. Let me hear you cry now. All night long. 96 tears. Yeah, come on now. 96 tears.
That right there was Question Mark and the Mysterious.
All right. Right now, we are going to interrupt the music because we have a caller on the air. Caller, are you there?
Hey, how's it going, Primo?
Hey, it's going good, man. Hey, the reason I'm calling you, Primo Louie, is because you guys are out there in San Pedro at Cruise by the Sea, right?
Yeah, yeah.
And you're with Latin Gents Car Club.
Yeah, Land Gents Car Club, yeah.
Yeah, man, what we're going to do is we're going to play a video real quick since I have you on the line, dude. I was amazed, man. You guys have over 600 vehicles out there, huh?
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Well, that's awesome, man.
You know, we're having a good time out here, though.
Yeah, how's all the members from Latin Gents doing?
Yeah, they're doing pretty good. Everybody's doing pretty good out here.
Yeah.
We're all having a good time dancing out there, and they have a live band out here.
Right on.
Yeah.
There we go, man. We're checking out you guys cruising in right now. You guys are out. What time did you guys cruise in?
Uh-huh.
What time did you guys cruise in over there?
We cruised in like about, it was about 8 o'clock,
7:30
around there.
Yeah, man. And I was, you know, the pictures look amazing.
Probably 600 bars, so, you know.
Yeah, yeah, right on, man. Well, you know, I just wanted to give a shout-out to the Latin Gents and all the car clubs that are out there participating at Cruise by the Sea. Have you been out there before, JoJo? Is your mic on?
There you go.
Yeah, you never been out there?
I've never been out there. I've cruised by the sea.
What about you, Jeannie? You ever been out?
Never.
Ever been? Well, look at that, man. There's over 600 cars. They're just cruising in, and just miles and miles of cars just hanging out. They're out there at the ocean, man, over in San Pedro in Port. What's the name of it? Portugal?
What's that?
What's the name of it? Where are you at right now?
Hang on, 3 more weeks.
Okay.
Hold on, there's a cop. Hey, there's a cop. I'll put my phone down.
That's it. Probably.
What was that again, Primo?
Where are you guys at? You guys are near San Pedro, right?
Yeah, we're in San Pedro, yeah.
It's called what?
Actually, close to Portugal, yeah.
Portugal, yeah. So,
yeah.
Wow, man. What an amazing event, man. And, you know, shout out again to all the Latin gents out there, okay? And we'll talk to you later. Take care.
Uh-huh.
Bye.
Okay, Primo. Well, thanks for calling, man.
All right. Thank you, Joe, for running that video, man.
Okay, bye.
Take care. We hang up? All right. All right, so that was out there at San Pedro at Portugal, and you know, Latin Gents car clubs out there, over 600 cars out there at that event. And with us right now, we have Janine. She's the store manager in the city of Carson for T-Mobile, and that's the phone service that I use, and I've been pretty happy with them.
Good
and
for you.
Thank you, Jeannie. Except for yesterday, my phone kind of gave out when I was downloading some stuff, but I think it's my fault because I don't have enough memory in there. So, you know, I'm always taking pictures and using up my memory and my minutes and stuff like that. But I've been really happy. My wife and I have had T-Mobile, I want to say over 18 years maybe.
Wow.
You know, we've been big fans. So tell us, why should we go with T-Mobile?
Well, why not is always my answer. You get unlimited calling, text, and web. No contracts, no hassles. You get the phones that you want at a lower cost. And definitely, all I'd say is come talk to us, because there's a lot of people that have like a lot of unexpected overages that are always popping up on their bills, their termination fees, and even contracts that they really hate that we can definitely help them with.
Right on, right on. And, you know, you just talked a little bit about it, but you really offer unlimited data, huh?
Yes, we do. We still offer it, meaning there's no caps on the fast internet that you're using. So being limited on the lifestyle habits that you have, as far as Netflix, Instagram, Pandora, Facebook, all that stuff that really uses up the data speeds, that's where we have a lot of customers that come looking for that unlimited. So instead of being stuck to that Wi-Fi or the fear of not being able to have that extra megabytes or the usage and stuff, mm-hmm. You can come over and there's no need to worry because we have that LTE network.
All right, right on, man. And then tell us about a new program that I'm kind of trying to get familiar with, and that's Jump on Demand.
Yeah, so this is really the best way to go with T-Mobile right now. So you get the phones that you want with no additional upgrade fees, and you don't have to wait. So basically you have 3 times in 1 year that you get a new phone. That's tomorrow, next week, or next month. Simply trade in the phone, the smartphone that you have, in working condition, and then we go ahead and take the rest. So you don't have to worry about paying off balances as far as any additional costs. So basically you do an 18-month lease, and then within that 1 year you can trade in your phone 3 times. So what's great about this, Paul, is that there's no additional cost or interest either to customers. So as a customer, you have the control in your hands where you can upgrade when you want at a low monthly fee. There's specific phones that we have for it. There's the LG G4, the iPhone 6, 6 Plus, and even the new Samsungs that are out.
Wow. Yeah, and I just got me a new HTC. Where is it at? It's right there.
Oh, the M9.
Yeah, the M9. Love it, man. Beautiful phone.
Best camera has the best front-facing camera for all those selfies, by the way.
Yeah, but I like the gold trim around it, too. It's silver with gold, you know, kind of like the way I like my cars, you know, all custom and shiny and everything.
Let's see what he has on here.
He's going through his pictures.
Hey, wait a minute. Give me that. No, just kidding. And is it true that you guys are also giving away free tablets?
Yeah, so new and current customers are qualifying based on the accounts that they have for the new Pixie. So it's a great Android tablet with a front-facing camera and a rear one, and it's a perfect size for purses and even some people's pockets. So you pay the service fee of $10 a month, and that would get you a match your data depending on what internet plan you have on your plan. And then the installment plan that you're supposed to pay for, T-Mobile takes care of it. All so right. You can see the stores for any details on that.
Okay, and then I know you talked a little bit about some of the promotions you got going, but what other promotions, like iPhones G6 or the new Galaxy Note?
Yeah, definitely. So with the current currently with the jump on demand, you trade in any working smartphone, and it could be from another carrier, and we basically offer you a monthly credit on your bill. So it, you can get an iPhone 6 for as low as $15 a month, and then the 6 Plus for $19. It just has to have a working phone. You can turn it on and no water damage or physical damage on there. Also, with the Note 5, that's Samsung's new next big thing, basically. It's my personal favorite and the one that I'm currently using. This is also eligible for a jump on demand, along with 6 other devices. Not for the credit on the monthly, but definitely for a low value. And if you do still have a smartphone to trade in, we can see if we give you any trade-in credit for that towards the down payment of your new phone. So everything that I mentioned is all for our new postpaid plans. It's the Simple Choice, which actually now includes our free North America calling to Canada and Mexico. So basically, it'd be like a local call here. And so with all these promotions, it's for working devices with no damage. And then I really encourage people to check out T-Mobile.com or come visit the local store. Our store is off the 405 in Carson, next to the IKEA.
Okay, and if they wanted to contact you or one of contact your store, you have a number they can call?
Yeah, definitely. It's the Carson location. It's 310-527-6421.
310-527-6421. So if you guys need a service plan or you're looking to change carriers, you know, definitely give the Carson location a call, the T-Mobile store, and Janine or one of her friendly staff members will be more than happy to help you out. And Ben, JoJo, you guys have any questions?
What would you make, or excuse me, rephrase that. What would you tell me to separate? What would you tell me to drop my Verizon account? I've been with Verizon since 1996.
1996. Well, what's your favorite thing about it, first of all, is what I want to know.
I'll tell you what favorite things I don't like about it. It's easier. The payments.
The payments?
I've had the i4, let me see. This one here, what I have.
Okay.
Maybe I have the new Droid. This thing lasts forever.
Hey, look, compare mine to yours. I guarantee you my bill's
but
cheaper.
But when I'm riding
yours.
My bicycle, man. That's a big thing. It's like a TV. No, those are nice. But
so one of the main things that people say as far as the comparisons is we can definitely, we have what, we don't lie to our customers, right? So we have our data calculators, which actually monitor how much data that you're using. So we can actually see what it is that you're using and get you that unlimited plan so that you're not suffering from any slow speeds or any buffering or even any overages.
Because, I mean, really, I love Verizon. But I'm honestly, because I have the no limit, you have no
unlimited. Unlimited, truly unlimited.
Define unlimited.
Unlimited. I watch my YouTube, Netflix, all my favorite shows without any buffering. Like, it just continues to go. I don't even have to depend on Wi-Fi at home. So I just like the ability of going wherever I want with no data
and
issues.
Your monthly prices on this?
Monthly prices.
I'm not playing because I got to get four.
Well, yeah. You want to come to their store and we'll give you more details on that.
I think that's gonna definitely take some time, you know? And we definitely got another guest that's who's waiting to be on the air also. But Janine, what about you, Ben? Did you have any questions real quick?
No, man. Brief? I'm really good right now.
Thank you.
Good.
All right. You know, I know one of the things that we're going to be getting into, JoJo, is we're going to start getting into Skype. We already have Skype here within the station. So I know that's why I bought my phone or got an upgrade finally. I got an upgrade because, you know, I want to go out to our events, our car shows, our, you know, whatever we have coming up, and we'd be able to air live from out there from the event right into our engineer, Joe, here. And we've done that in the past, and I wanted one of the better phones. So
yeah, as you were telling me yesterday, because I just picked up a tablet from Verizon that had the internet on it, but I'm still paying. So I might be talking to you sooner than you think.
Yeah. All right. So, yeah, definitely you need to grab Jeanine before she leaves today, man, and upgrade that tablet. And, Jeanine, do you want to say hi to anybody out there before we go back to some great music with Ben?
I think for me, it would just be my very supportive team. Right now, they're hustling out there without me, and they have Ashley as their leader right now. So I definitely appreciate everything they do for me, and just special shout-outs to the best team out there.
Right on, man. That takes a good manager to recognize her team. So you guys keep up the great work. Ashley, the T-Mobile team out there in the city of Carson, and thank you for being here today. And we're going to go back to Ben Valdepeña with some great classical music. Thank you.
Thank you.
The late, great Marvin Gaye.
Good afternoon, and you're listening to the Paul Rasso Commish Show along with JoJo from Devotions Entertainment and our DJ right here, our special DJ from First Class Entertainment, Mr. Ben Valdepeña. And with us right now is we have an honorary guest right here. We have Mr. Bill Hussey with the City Council in Grand Terrace. You were appointed and sworn in the office this past January, right? Correct?
Correct.
And you also served on the bond committee for the Colton Joint Unified School District?
Yeah, I was on the bond B and G committee for that for approximately maybe 5 years.
Oh, okay, Bill. So how's things going?
All right, well, first of all, thank you for having me here today. It's an honor and to talk about my city that I got appointed to. It's going really good. You know, we're doing some good things in Grand Terrace, and I'm looking forward to the future there.
Right on. And so tell us a little bit, since your appointment, I know, you know, you have a passion to be involved and do great things. And I know you're passionate enough that you want to see your city thrive. And how is the journey going as a Grand Terrace council member for you?
Well, one thing that I wouldn't know if it's fortunate enough that it's all uphill journey for me. It's, you know, like any city, we got hit hard by the RDA when Governor Brown took our money from these little cities, you know, to help us sustain money to keep our services going. But, you know, we're moving forward. We're, you know, there's actually light at the end of the tunnel. It's just if we stay on the path and continue to everybody put their best foot forward, and the city staff are doing a great job for, you know, what limited staff that we have. You know, my hat's off to them. They are just working their hearts out for our city.
Yeah, you know, those funding decreases, you know, with, you know, the city that the government took, you know, away, you know, with for development, you know, then we're having new issues with the water drought, you know, and I know cities are out there trying to do what they can to increase revenues and money allocation from the state. What is Grand Terrace doing to locally deal with those issues of lost funding?
Well, like any city, where everybody's scrambling, but, you know, when I first got on there, we'll step back about a year ago when we really went through some financial difficulties. We brought an intern, Ken Henderson. He's actually the city manager for out there in Apple Valley area, and he did a lot of development up there, and he really helped our city on the right path. And then he left after, right the same day I got sworn in, and we got another intern, Carol Jacobs, and she was there a couple months, and we just hired another city manager, Harold Duffy. He came out of Compton and Otisville, and he's done a really great job, you know, he came in rolling up his sleeves. Mm-hmm. We're looking at, you know, a mission statement. You know, we want to improve public safety, financial responsibility, better communication with the residents, infrastructure, maintenance, partnership, skateboard park. I just got through talking to somebody about the skateboard park. Mm-hmm. But over the last 90 days, we have workshops. We want everybody involved in our city. We want to hear the voice of the people. And to do that, we have the workshops going and to hear the community's, you know, input. We're trying to give back to our city. We just came back with a $25,000 community benefit fund. We're trying to give it to the nonprofit organizations on that. And we're repairing major potholes. So we're doing little steps at a time to try to bring our city back.
Right, right. And I remember before you got appointed, I know that that previous November, you know, I think one of the city council members and the former mayor were advocating, you know, for I think it was a property tax, you know, to help the city. But the majority of the community decided to vote against it, and it didn't happen. So is it correct to, you know, that at that time the city had to they had to do some reductions and some cuts in the administration, correct?
Paul,
we're cracking up here. We're losing. Hopefully the listeners are still. What's going on? Which mic is it? Okay.
All right. So, can you hear me?
Yeah. We're.
It was a utility tax that it was presented to the voters. I was on the committee for that. It was a hard decision to make. It was recommended that we needed extra revenue to keep our doors open. And we came to conclusion on utility tax so everybody in the city could help out instead of just hitting the property owners. And
we lost sound again, Joe. We're losing sound for some reason. Can you hear us in the boot? Yeah? Oh, okay.
We didn't have much sales tax revenue up there. We have very limited businesses up there, so we couldn't survive on if we increased the sales tax. And we didn't want to do that to our small business owners on the sales tax. But so what they did, they cut hard. They cut, you know, a lot of city staff. We had to cut down the sheriff's department, and that's one of our biggest revenues is $1.6 million that we're paying out in the San Bernardino County Sheriff's. That's an increase of 4.5%. But we did a lot of cuts, and then my hat's off to the, you know, city council. They really had to roll up their sleeves back then and do some hard decisions. But, you know, we were able to keep our parks open. We were able to just do the basic minimum service just to survive and maintain our sovereignty there. But in the meantime, you know, time takes its toll, and, you know, we cut, and we end up having a $450,000 surplus after that cut, because you have to have so much money in your reserve. And property value, thank goodness, it went up 7% this year, so we're able to get some additional revenue there. We're able to get some additional revenue on services. We're having some developers come in, they're building, so that's fees that we're collecting there. So we're getting some of that back. We had a economic development and good problems within the city of Grand Terrace. We're expecting a $250 million worth of construction to occur in Grand Terrace from 2010 to 2020.
Wow.
As you know, the Grand Terrace High School, that was $50 million alone.
Correct.
And then the big thing is that Barton Road project, you know, that's $80 million, so they're redoing the freeway right there.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, we're still working on it. We're still trying to get money on there, and that's the big thing. You know, like, we just balanced the budget here June of 2015 at $4.5 million for a general fund, and we're getting a bigger surplus back. You know, we're a conservative city. The council, we all agree on it. We want to be safe for a rainy day. You know, the extra money comes in, we don't want to just, you know, spend it on nothing. We want to save and use it for the right thing. And we're able to, you know, we're starting to give a little bit back to our employees. You know, we have a great child care system up there that's, you know, pretty much self-sufficient. And we're able, you know, we're looking at hiring a couple, you know, part-time people to help out with our city on there. But it's coming. It's a long road, but, you know, we have to maintain our path and our vision on there.
Correct. That's right. So, well, those are some of the great things that the, you know, that are going on in your city, you know, to bring in revenue. And that's wonderful, Bill. That's great, positive news. You know, I know it's tough. I know Bill and I, and I think JoJo also, you know, we're in the employees unions, and, you know, we've had to go through, you know, reductions and layoffs these last few years, you know, and it's been tough for everybody. You know, and some people got hurt by it, and you know, it's tough decisions that you have to make as a leader of your community.
Yeah, it's a tough decision, and you know, it takes a, you know, I wasn't there to make the cuts, and I'm in a way fortunate I didn't have to do that. I'm walking into, I would say, you know, not the ideal situation, but it's going straight forward. I mean, we have a good council, and we're all working together. We all have the same goals there. We have, like I said, Mr. Duffy, our city manager, he's leading the way, and all the city staff are coming together. And, you know, like I said, you know, God bless them. They're working hard. And, you know, hopefully one day, you know, we'll have a full complement in City Hall. We'll have them back up to full time. And that's what, you know, have a great, great group. But, you know, like I was saying about the budget, too, we're also we're trying to do on the I-215, the main and Barton Road is expected to have a total build out approximately $100 million value. But we're looking at to develop 100 acres there. And we also have some other projects on Barton that's under development. And we're expecting to get a Starbucks back. You know, that Starbucks is a big time.
Yeah.
And Stater Brothers is talking about building a couple more.
Go ahead.
The Stater Brothers is going to build a couple more buildings there on each side, so that'll bring another revenue. So, you know, if our property value is up 7% and we get
you're good.
And we continue moving forward on it, then I think we'll be stabilized on that part. But, you know, our sales tax base is – can you hear me?
Yeah, we can hear you.
Yeah, you know, we lost, you know, but then again, you know, you step forward a couple steps and you come backwards because we lost another business with revenue going in. But we're, you know, we're trying to get him back over, and that's a big tax base right there. So,
right on. But, well, you know, I know you have probably a big fan base out there in Grand Terrace, too. And they're, you know, we're live right now on the air. Is, do you have anyone you want to give a shout out to? And,
well, I have a couple things I like to pass on. First of all, I like to give a shout out to all our volunteers. That's what really takes care of our city, the volunteers too.
Yep.
They are, you know, when times are tough and the doors are closing, you'll get a volunteer there. I mean, Grand Terrace is full of volunteers. We have all kinds of, you know, we have the Lions Club, of course. We have the Chamber that does a great job with the businesses. We have, you know, Friends of Blue Mountain. We're opening up a dog park. We have dog park volunteers. We have volunteers out there in the Little League, soccer, basketball, you name it, we got volunteers. We have a youth center there. You know, it's ran for actors school activities and stuff. You know, they're volunteer. All that's volunteer. That's what's keeping our city grand. And another thing that we got going on, we're going to have a Freedom Wall built at Pico Park. And if we're having a run on, I think, September 27th, a 5K run at 8 o'clock. And if you want to participate, it's like $40. You just look on the Facebook and it's Grand Terrace Lions Club, and you'll see 5K run there. So, and that's another thing. And we have that wall being built, and you could dedicate a plaque. It's like $100 for a plaque. You could put your name or anybody's name. It doesn't have to be a service member in Grand Terrace. It could be a service member anywhere that served or live in the city, but your name will be permanently on that wall, on the Freedom Wall. And that's one good way to honor the veterans. You know, we don't have that many flagpoles, so we did a wall. So
yeah, that's great. But then with Veterans Day coming up on November 11th.
Yeah, and that's what we're hoping to do on November 11th on that thing. We're going to open, you know, that's, as it goes to plan, that's going to be our grand opening, and it's going to be the dedication of that Freedom Wall. And Jim, the mayor's wife there, he's steamheading that thing. But, you know, just look on, the, like I said, Facebook, and it's
City
right
of
there,
Grand Terrace.
City of Grand Terrace. Our website on the Lions Club website, but you know we also have our website where you could just pull it up. You just Google City of Grand Terrace, and everything information is there. But like I said, I want to thank everybody and thank you for being, you know, having me here, Paul. And
absolutely.
And we're just going to move forward. And you know, Grand Terrace is a great city. You know, it's, you know, population is 13,000, but everybody knows everybody. And you know, we're right next door to Colton, and we work good with Colton and Loma Linda, so it's great. You know, and shout out to the mayor, Colton De La Rosa. Really nice guy.
I think we got a good city council team out there in the city of Colton, too. So I give them all a shout out, too. You know, Mayor De La Rosa, Mr. Navarro, David Toro, who we had, Isaac Sucho, Deidre Bennett, and who did I miss? Oh, Summer Zamora. And, you know, all great city council members out there. And listeners, if you, hopefully you all heard that. That's a 5K walk. Walk and run on Sunday, September 27th, happening there in the city of Grand Terrace, going for a good cause to build a Freedom Wall in honor of the veterans. And please look on Grand Terrace on Facebook, Grand Terrace City Council. Get the information there. If you need additional information, feel free to call the radio station at 1-888-909-1050. And leave a message for me, Paul Rosso, the commish, and I'll get that information to you. And Bill, thank you for being here today. You know, it's an honor having you. And I wanted to reach out a little bit to Grand Terrace, and I think we did that. And thank you for coming out.
Well, thank you. Any time, you know, I like to let everybody know what's going on in our city. And
yeah. Well, you just give me that phone call and let me know, and we'll make some more time for you.
All right. Well, thank you, and God bless.
God bless you, man. Right. And we're going to go back to Mr. Ben Valdepena. You guys didn't have any questions for Bill, right?
No,
you guys
are all good? Yeah, because, you know. Okay. Actually, I did. Your wall, I mean, because my father served. He was just sitting here.
Oh, yeah.
All his uncles served. So I really, you know, keep basis with you on that. And on your 5K walk, if you don't have entertainment, let Paul or I know. And we'll get you guys some clean, good entertainment.
Okay, sounds good. I'll let the Lions Club know, and we'll get a hold of you. Because they're the ones sponsoring it, and they're doing the wall. But, it's a really good event. I did it last year. Of course, I did it last year right after our Alaska cruise, and I ate too much food. So I was, like, walking really slow. But this is our second. Yeah, I was in the back supporting everybody. But, yeah, I appreciate it.
I don't know, joking around, Bill, the last cholo I seen was actually running. All right, we're going to go to Ben Valdepena with some great music.
We'll be right back. Uno, dos, one, two, tres, cuatro.
This is the Commish, and JoJo Sanchez coming at you right now. And we just want to make some announcements about some of the events that are going on. Saturday, September 5th, the Aztec Riders are having their third anniversary celebration at the Moose Lodge from 4 to 9 in the city of Mentone. And they invite the public and everyone to come on out. And that's the Silpati chapter out there in the city of Yucaipa. So they're having their third annual anniversary. And you can find their information on actually on my Facebook at Paul Rosso the Commish. Look them up. Come out. Enjoy some great music and some great food. And JoJo and I and the Suavecito squad will be going out there. Huh? We'll be providing some of the entertainment out there, right?
Exactly. We're playing the breaks for the band.
There you go. So come on out. Enjoy the third annual anniversary with the Aztec Riders. And then we also have some other events coming up on Sunday, September 12th. This is being sponsored by City's Finest and the American Legion Riders in the city of Colton. It's a fundraiser for our angel Victoria Sanchez, who has a rare heart disease, 14-year-old Victoria Sanchez. And it's a motorcycle and car show along with a dinner and a dance fundraiser. We have pre-registration. It's $15. $20 for cars and trucks the day of the event, $10 for motorcycles. There's going to be trophies, raffles, food, vendors, outside entertainment being provided by Kcaa Radio, the Commish, CX2, along with DJ Manny Blaze will be out there. And during the dance, from 8 p.m. to midnight, we're going to have Carlos Alba out there. We're going to have Mr. Ramon Gutierrez from X-Ray Productions. And we'll have the Flamingo Band in the house. So come on out, and that will be $10 per person. And come on out that evening. And JoJo, you got something going on, right?
Yeah, I do. I got the Colton Family Cruise Night, Friday, September 18th, 6 to 9 p.m. at Al Aguila Rail Restaurant right there on 865 North Rancho Avenue in Colton. That's the one you do every month, correct?
Yeah, that's the one that we're at every month. Myself and DJ CX2, unless she brings someone else to DJ that night.
I'll turn off my phone.
You'll turn off.
No ice.
Yeah, I try to go out there and just enjoy and let her play those jams, those old school, oldies that she loves to play, man. And then also coming October 10th, we have the Rendezvous Route 66. Car show happening. So, come on out and enjoy that. That's from 10 to 10 p.m. on Saturday, October 10th, 2015. You can pick up registration forms here at Kcaa Radio, or you can look up, you can call 885-7515. And with that, man, we're going to go back to some music, unless you got anything else, JoJo.
Yesterday, how about, did you, tired?
Yes, man, it was hot out there, dude, but we did it, you know. It was a great event. You know, I just want to give a shout-out to our young ladies right here in the city of San Bernardino, Alive in the Lights, man. Those young ladies, that band, what an awesome band, dude. And, yeah. I think those young ladies are going to make it big time, bro.
It was cool because, as you know, our show started Friday night with Aldo. And these girls, they played, and they didn't know they had artists. And Aldo Gonzalez is a drummer.
Right, right. Aldo Gonzalez.
You know, Night Owl Art was in there. He wanted numbers.
And the stories, dude. Yeah. You know, it was a no-stopping youth event in the city of Colton yesterday, man. And basically, you know, educating adults and teens about the dangers of underage drinking. But the stories, dude, I didn't realize the stories behind, you know, like Jimmy Sincerely from well-known artist, Christian oldie artist, well-known in the Victory Outreach community, you know, and his story, bro. I did not know his story. West Coast Il-V, man, his story, bro. And, you know, and then we had High Power Little G out there. You know, their stories were amazing.
Does not drink. Yeah. Little D does not drink alcohol at all as of some years ago.
Yeah.
And when he meets his fans and sells his CDs or when he goes out and about, his fans bring him sodas and waters.
Yeah. Well, I'm just glad that they all showed up, dude, because the kids actually interviewed each and every one of them. And the kids were amazed by the stories that they shared, dude. And they're, and you know, the question that, that was asked by the kids was, you know, why are you here today? And the biggest response is to say, you know what? We're here today because what we did when we were growing up, we don't want you guys to do.
Yes.
You know, and it was just an amazing day, man. I mean, great people. Appreciate all the people that came out, man, supported the event.
Yeah,
man.
We did. We had comedian, San Bernardino comedian, Anthony Stone. Yeah. We had,
You know what? I think we got about a minute on the air still. How much longer we have there, Joe? 1 minute. So, you know, go ahead real quick, bro. Yeah,
we actually had the last shot to River Cash from Straight Royalty, and Mesa Furgon was out there, too.
Yeah, man. Some amazing artists out there, bro. And thank you, JoJo, for the help putting that together. And
no problem. You know. Actually, last shout out, I know. I like to thank my mom for letting us use the RV, but it got impounded last night. So I didn't tell you that.
Well, no.
But I know she's listening. Yeah. Someone's got to tell you.
So, all right, man. So with that being, we're going to let you wrap it up and have a great afternoon. Be safe out there. Hopefully you're home barbecuing and staying safe. And this is a commish, man. So remember, live the American dream, cruise low and slow.
You're on board KCAA's Inland Talk Express. KCAA, Loma Linda, 1050 AM. The station that leaves no listener behind.
Your NBC Sports Radio update starts now.
All day, every day. I'm Dave Joseph. Just 2 weeks after capturing his first major championship, Jason Day cruised to a six-stroke victory at the Barclays. Day fired a final round 8-under 62 to finish